All right, so, ow,
my head,
that hurt. All right, I am going to attempt to remove the serpentine belt from this Cummins ISV 6.7. It's in a Thor Motor Coach Palazzo diesel pusher. So I'm at the rear of the motorhome. And so what I went ahead and did to get everything out of my way is I went ahead and removed the air filter and the air filter bracket mount, whatever you want to call it, that's bolted to the side of the chassis. So got that out of the way. And actually, I mean, I could probably get in here and get to what I need, but just to make it a little easier for me and so I can see everything going on, I think I'm going to go ahead and also remove this turbo intercooler hose. That way I can get in here and just have pretty much free access to everything I need. And I really don't know if I need to go to this extreme, but I just think it'll give me more room to get in here and work and look at things. And my tensioner is actually right down there on my lights pointing. So I'm sure by removing this intercooler pipe, it's gonna give me a whole lot of room, because I gotta put my come along bar, or not come along bar, but my breaker bar in there to loosen that tensioner. And we'll go from there. So that's what we're doing. Catch y'all in a few minutes. I don't even know how in the world I'm getting my... Let's see if I just get it in there. Let's see. I mean, the only way I'll get in there is to go straight up like this. Okay, I got it in there. And I guess I pull... God, let's see. Can y'all even see this? I'm way up here with my... Well, that was easy enough. I don't even know how I'm gonna release it. It's easy to move. I mean, it's... Okay. We're back in business. Let me break this down for y'all. So, what I was doing was, first of all, I was using a bar that was too big. Don't need all that shit. That was too big. That right there is what I need, something smaller. And to top it off, I was going the wrong way with the belt. I mean, with the tensioner. I should have went, I should have pushed it down instead of up. So, whatever. One damn thing about it, I stretched that belt good, because I was going the wrong way with it. So we sure as hell gonna put a new belt on here now. Ain't no doubt about that. So I got it loose. And there's the belt. And she is cracked. I am so glad I decided to replace this belt. 20,000 miles, 7.5 years old. And it's back here in a what I would consider a pretty brutal environment with this rear diesel end pusher. So, I hope y'all can see what I'm doing with this camera on my head. So, all right, so, the first two pulleys it's coming off of is air conditioning compressor, alternator, and if y'all can see this, that right there is the tensioner. It does not go up to release it, it goes down. And if you can see my finger right there, that's the flywheel. And then up here is the fan clutch and the fan. So really, those are the only things this belt goes around on the back of this Cummins. So let's go ahead and get this thing off, guys. I hope I can get it off. Like I said, this is uncharted territory for me. I have no idea how in the world I'm going to unroute it. And you cannot get your hands in here at all. It's almost next to impossible. You gotta be Houdini. You gotta be a Houdini. All right, so there's the water pump. Got it. I loosened it from the water pump right there, if y'all can see that. So now, and it's gonna have to go somehow or another all the way around this fan. Lord have mercy. I don't even know. Whew. That's why they pay the RV techs, excuse me, the mechanics, the big bucks, boys. This right here is exactly why. Y'all keep that in mind. If y'all buy one of these motorhomes, if you're not able-bodied or not mechanically inclined enough to work on them yourself, you're gonna be paying somebody a whole bunch of money to fix them yourself. I mean, to fix them for you. All right, so I'm going around here. I am on the flywheel right here. And you probably see my hands right here. I'm gonna pull the belt. Oh God, where's the... Boy, that belt, it goes way up in there. Jesus, think. All right, so I have released it from the flywheel. Listening to Super Tramp in the back ain't helping the situation, I'm just gonna tell you right now. Right now. Okay. Now, I got it loose from the flywheel. So basically, it's all, I mean, pretty much it's all loose except for around that fan. And I still don't know how I'm gonna get it out from around that fan. I'm gonna have to probably fish it around between the radiator shroud and the fan. We're getting ready to figure this out in just a minute. So, let's see. Bruh, I have no idea. All right, so, okay, so there's the, so right now, the only thing that's left hung on is the fan, and I can turn it. Listen, what's that noise? Okay. All right, so, let me get my light. So here's what we got. You gotta be Houdini. So there's the fan. And that's, it is literally loose from everything. I don't even know how in the world. Bro, okay, let's see. How's this gonna work? mean, I could cut it, but that would be stupid because you got to put a new one on there. Bruh. I don't know how in the world this is going to work. Got to go around the fan with it, just like that. You got to get it behind the fan. It may. I mean, there's no way it's gonna come free unless I undo one little thing left here, my fan clutch wires. I don't wanna undo that, but that's the only way it's gonna come loose. All right, hang on, y'all. I'll be back in a minute. I think I have to, I guess that's why it's got a screw. You have to unloosen that to get it around from your fan clutch. I'll be right back. Hang on. All right. All right. So now I'm going to take off. I'm going to remove the fan clutch wires and fan clutch bracket. That's the only way I can figure out how to get the belt off of here. Where was I? So I was right here. Let me get my wrench. I got her. And it's a very tight spot. It's hard to get to. I don't even know how I'm going to get both hands in here to do this. I'm gonna have to hold the rent. I'm gonna have to hold that one with one. And this hurts because my arms are so tight in here. There, I just loosened it up. Got it. Uh-oh. Keep on dropping tool. That's the other problem. Boy, this ain't easy. If it was easy, everybody could do it, right? Alright. Alright, he ain't going nowhere. Mercy. This ain't, they don't make them easy to work on, guy. And I'm about halfway on that one. Let's see here what I got going on. Is it loose? You know, maybe it just comes undone. Let's see. Nope. I don't know what's behind it. I can't see. It's got a clip right here. It's got to come all the way. So that's rubber. Okay. Lord have mercy. I'll be amazed to get those back together like it's supposed to be. Whew. I don't even know if it's loosening. I don't know what's going on. I can't see anything. And my arm's killing me. I heard the wire. But I don't know how it won't come, it will not loosen any more than that. Huh. It's like this right here is not this nut. Well, I guess it is. Let me see if I can spin it. Oh, the whole thing's spinning. Okay, I see. So the whole thing's got to come off. I mean, there's just no two ways about it. And I cannot have my light in here. I cannot hold my light anywhere. And there's nowhere to hang it. Maybe I can hang it up here. Let me try. And my knees are killing me. See, I'm down here on my knees. Up under the back of this thing. It's just, it's awful. It is just terribly awful. Maybe that'll work. That'll work. That's better. Maybe I'll have to stay there. I need some pads or something for my knees, and the best I got is a towel. And then there's dirt under that. Look at this right here, guys. Let me see, my arm's pinched in here. I can't see the other side of that nut. I can't see nothing. I mean, it's just horrible. I don't even know if y'all can see what I'm seeing. It's extremely hard to turn. Coming off, please tell me it's coming off. It must be because it's loose. You're gonna get a little bit of a turn on it at the time. Whew. Just think, I gotta put it back on. It won't go on today though. There, because I believe I got it. Oh. All right, diesel RV mechanics, I know why they pay you the big bucks. Because, oh Lord, I still can't turn it. I gotta have the wrenches on it. You can't even, when you think you can turn it with your fingers because the wrench is so loose, there is no way it's gonna happen. All right, just a couple more turns and she's off. I don't wanna lose my nut there. It, I got it, boy. And the nut, is there a washer in it? No, there's no washer. There might be a washer on the other side. There's the nut. I don't know what's on. There's like a lot of stuff on the other side of this thing. There's the nut. Okay, there's the, I gotta undo the wire now. What kind of wretched mess is this? There's the nut. I figured there'd be a washer on the back side of it, and there he is. So now I gotta unplug the wire. Alright. I gotta unplug this wire. And clutch is disconnected. And this is gonna hang. There it goes right there. Now we can get the serpentine belt off. That easy. Haha. That you have to do, and I cannot crank this thing up and move it. Well, I could technically, because that fan is not going to spin at all. Because I have to move the motorhome now. I can't leave it where it's sitting. So it's got to go around this fan, it's got to go behind it. If I can get it all the way around. If I just keep on going around this fan, I think I got it. I believe I about got it. Ooh, have I got it? I got it, thank God. Woo! One serpentine belt off a 6.7. Cummins ISB on a diesel pusher. Let's get out from under this damn thing. Well, before we do that, hang on. Let me check some things. So the real reason why I did this was, well, obviously to replace the serpentine belt. The other reason was to, and make sure it goes back in there. The other reason was to check my water pump. That's in there. I see why it's rubber now, because they don't, you don't want your wire to come out. Okay, you want it to stay there so it doesn't get hit by them. Anyway, all right, so the fan is good, fan clutch is good, nothing is wobbling on the fan. The most important thing is the water pump, and y'all probably can't see it, is right here. I'm gonna make sure it's not wobbling. It's not. And the water pump feels good. Feels real good. I don't know, actually, you know what? Hang on. Let me turn this music off so we can hear this fan. I'm gonna put the camera real close to it and we're gonna spin it again because I want some people to listen to it. Oh, my knees. Woo. Roscoe, I'm too old for this. You're such a good dog, though, boy. That dog will, he will sit with me and just lay there and be a good boy all day. And he's such a loyal dog. He will sit there and watch you work all day and follow you any and everywhere you go. He's a good boy. You're a good boy. Yes, I am, Daddy. I'm a good boy. I'm a good boy. He knows it, too. Oh, man, you know, grease in your eye. I'm sorry, buddy.